Hello, my name is Xander. Welcome to the ORM Mastery Course, Level 1 for Beginners. This tutorial is part of the YouTube edition playlist, Django Database ORM Mastery. You can find a link to this playlist in the video description, where you'll find all the tutorials associated to this course. In this tutorial, we learn how to insert data into a single table utilizing the save function. If you would like to follow along step by step, you can download our base Django project, code base 1. There is a link in the video description to that code. Now, if you are not familiar with Django and how to start a new Django project, there is also a video guide on how to download and start the project. Again, there is a link in the video description to that. If you like this course and would like to learn more, then do consider our course on Udemy, Django Database ORM Mastery Level 1. The actual thumbnail might change over time, but just look for Created by Very Academy. There is a link in the video description to the course. That is always going to give you the best price for the course. So here we are working with code base 1. If you are following this tutorial series from the previous section, you probably will find that we're using code base 1 there. So there's nothing you need to do additionally to set this up. Like I said at the start there, if you do want to set this up exactly how I have and follow along, then have a look at the setup guide at the start of this section of the course. So I will be utilizing the terminal here primarily to showcase these queries. And for those who are new to Django, that can sometimes feel a little bit abstract, a little bit strange, being that most of the code that you write will be in a view. So I will, at the end of this tutorial, just transfer our knowledge over to a view to give you that kind of stepping stone over to kind of converting what we're doing in the terminal over to the view so that you can maybe start to apply it within your project. So for this tutorial, we are going to be focusing in on the brand table. We're going to keep it nice and simple in this section, in this kind of underpinning section. So we're going to focus here on the brand table. So there are three fields in this brand table: brand ID, name, and nickname. So as I alluded to already, potentially, I've already migrated the project if you have downloaded the Codebase 1. So the tables are ready to go. I've already created them. You can have a look in models here, and you can see that there should be an SQLite database ready for us to start. So first thing we're going to do, we're going to be working in the shell here initially. And like I said, if you hang on, I will show you how to apply that within a view, the code in the view. So we're going to be utilizing the shell. So this shell is a Python shell kind of wrapped around Django. So we can utilize Django commands, etc., work with Django. So let's go ahead and now activate or make ready the brand table. So first thing we're going to need to do in the terminal is just lock in. I've got this file, extra file here, which you won't have. I'm going to write the commands there. I'll just copy and paste the commands in so that you can start typing them. Predominantly, I will copy and paste a lot in. Maybe the first time I use a command, I will type it out and explain. And then from that point, I'll just go ahead and copy and paste it in. Okay, so we do need to make this available in our terminal so we can access the brand table. There we go. So let's just check to see what's inside the brand table. If you're following along from previous tutorials, there might be something there. So brand.objects.all. That will show me what's inside the brand table. There's one item. So what I can do here, I'll just copy and paste that in. What I can do here is I can delete them all. And this is just skipping a few tutorials, of course. But if I use the delete function here at the end, that's just going to delete everything from the database and we can start fresh. Okay, so let me just copy and paste that up. There we go. So we now know how to collect all the data and delete it. So let's now add data to the database. Right, so I press the shortcut on my computer here. And Windows, it's slightly different, but Command K, that would just remove that so we can see what we're doing. So let's add some data to the database. Right, so we need to first of all define what table we want to add to the database. We use the objects, the manager, and then we use the create command, or the create function. So this create function here, this is going to allow us to define essentially the fields and the data that we want to insert into the into the table. So if we look at the table, we have brand ID. Now, for this table, I've manually created a primary key, just so for us to experiment with that. Now, if we didn't use the brand table, if we utilize the product table, that already has Django will automatically create an ID, a primary key for us. So it will automatically increment that data for us. So we won't see that with the brand table, but we will in a minute add some data maybe to the category table. So we'll explore that auto-incremented primary key. Right, so let's go back to the brand table and let's create some data. So we've got brand ID. So that needs to be an integer. And then we also have name. Now, I think we also have a nickname field. And again, that was just for us to be able to explore. We're not going to utilize that here. So let's go for our shoe, which is going to be Nike. So notice that when we execute that command, we're given indication of what's been added to the database. So it looks like everything is okay. If we did accidentally add or create an incomplete statement here, we would produce an error here, and it would give us some indication of what the problem is. Some other areas where you might receive errors, for example, if you try to insert data that is meant to be unique in the database. So let's try and insert or create this data here, and we return a unique constraint failed because we're trying to insert the brand ID one again, and that already exists in our database. If we go back to the models here, we will find in general that the primary key needs to be unique. So we can't have two primary keys with the same value. So we're trying to do that there by creating that new object. So therefore we receive the unique constraint failed. Now, of course, other fields can be unique, and we can see here that this name field is also been set to unique. So this name also needs to be unique throughout the whole table. Another error that you might receive is when you forget to include one of the required fields. So here, for example, we forget to include the primary key, which is a required field. So we return the not null constraint failed, and we're given indication that the brand ID needs to be included. The reality then of utilizing create in our project, in our Django project, is maybe the data would come from a form or maybe some sort of input, and that would then need to be formatted in preparation to then be inserted into the create. And that would be an interesting to showcase. Now, this section of the course is all about underpinning skills, so I won't go through that in its entirety, but let's look at how we could potentially apply this code inside of a Django view. So let's just explore the project here. We've got the core section here and the URLs. So let's go ahead, and we already have from inventory, we've already imported the views, which is referring to the views in the inventory section here. So that's all good. So let's go ahead and add a path. So typically we would have a path to the view, and that would fire off the view. So let's call this new. And then let's go for views. Dot, and then we call our view inside of our views, or we call our function, sorry, inside of our views, just new. Probably not the best naming convention in the world, but we'll give that a go. So that's a reference then to our inventory views here. So let's go ahead and create a new function called view new, and then we need to take in request. Now for this particular setup, we're going to return a HTTP response. So from Django.http, normally this would be a render if you're using templates. So let's import HTTP response. So that's just going to give us a response. So what we can do here is when we fire off this function, we can then return a HTTP response. So let's just say hi for now. So now we can test this in one of two ways, right? So here on my Mac, I can utilize curl. So I can send a curl request, or I could do if, for example, the server was active, right? So let's just go ahead and Python 3, manage.py, let's run the server. And we can see that we have an error, module not found, type in extensions. I'm not entirely sure where that is. Module. Okay, so let's go back into our models here. looks like we've got an error here. Very strange. I'm not entirely sure why that's there, so let's just remove that. Also, we can remove that. I'm not entirely sure how that got there. It might not be on yours. I might have already updated that. So you can see that the server now is running. So we just remind ourselves that we need to go to /new. So we can in our browser, let's type in 001:8000 and then go to /new. So you can see here we return hi. So that's just one way of accessing our new view. In addition to that, if you're on the Mac, for example, we could use curl. So we could say curl and then http://127.0.0.1/8000/new/ and there we go, we return hi. So we're just returning something there. So we can see that our view is now being connected. So going back to our previous code here, we created a new item. So typically we would see this code inside of a view, for example, and just go there. Now, of course, we are using brand. We need the brand resource, the brand table. So from dot models, a reference to the models module here, then let's import brand. There we go. So now you can see that it's connected. Or we can build that connection so we can actually add an item. Now, this item already exists. So let's just add a new item here. Now, of course, every time we visit this view, this is now going to be fired off and it's going to add a new item. And obviously, the first time it does that, then obviously it adds it. The second time it's going to cause an error because we know that there's some unique elements related to this entry, this brand ID. So let's just run this again, either in the browser or utilizing your terminal here, and you can see that it just returns hi. But what's interesting is if we then go into the shell, so let's go back into a new shell here. So apologies, I'm just going to add a new shell, python3manage.py/shell, and we're going to grab the database again. This is probably the longest way of doing this. And we can then see that the data has now been inserted. Now, if you are using the SQL extension, so here I have the SQLite extension, go ahead and install that. We can, of course, just go down into the database. So if I right click on the database, open the database, down the bottom here, I can then access all of the tables, one of them being brand. I can show the table and we can see the data has been inserted. So let's remember that if we were to run this in the shell here, we return a unique constraint failed. So we have an integrity error. So we can utilize that to actually build a try except here in our view. So let's go ahead and do that. So try brand, and then let's capture the error except. And that's the integrity error. So what we're going to do here is we're going to return a message. So let's go ahead and just put this return here. Sorry, we cannot add that. There we go. Okay, so because we're using integrity error, we're probably going to need to bring this in. So let's do that. So let's, from django.db, let's import integrity error. Okay, so it looks like it's going to work. So let's go back into our shell here. And we're just going to run our code. You can do this in the browser if you like. So this time, because the data already exists, it should return or should create an integrity error, in which case we should now return, sorry, we cannot add that. And there we go. Sorry, we cannot add that. So I have drawn you down this path using try except with this integrity error, and we have explored some of the other errors that you might receive using create. So it's well worth considering capturing those errors, or considering how you're going to capture those errors if you're using this create function. So there we have the basics of create, which Django refers to a convenience method for creating an object and saving it all in one step.